terkendali, and selamat malam. First of all, I would like to start by wishing bless Sasi Suro, New Year, Java New Year, for my beloved Surinamese brothers and sisters who celebrate. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, bless us all with good health and wealth and cover us with peace and happiness. It is truly an honor for me, Edwin, to be part of this year's commemoration of the 132nd years of the Javanese immigration to Suriname. We pay tribute, respect, and send prayers to the Simbah, our Simbah, our courageous ancestor who crossed the ocean and left their home in Indonesia to start new life, new beginning in Suriname. Your respected Simbah, our respected Simbah, have left a legacy to all of us here and to us the life we live and enjoy today. And with this legacy, the Javanese community has been well established as part of the Surinamese nation. And the presence of this Javanese community has become the strong bonds between Indonesia and this very nation, Suriname. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia now in this year is assuming the presidency of G20. G20 is a group of advanced and emerging economies. Indonesia has been assuming the presidency in December 1, 2021 and will be concluded on November 30, 2022 this year. And inclusiveness is the spirit of Indonesia's G20 presidency. Indonesia would like to see the G20 become a catalyst for concrete cooperation that benefits developing countries and other countries in the world. For this reason, Indonesia's G20 presidency will focus on strengthening global health architecture, energy transition, and digital transformation. Under the Indonesia's presidency, Indonesia would like to reach out as the president of G20 to other countries, to other developing countries. In this regard, apart from the member of the G20 themselves, which certainly will be invited to the G20 summit in November, but the Indonesian government also would like also inviting other member developing countries through the regional organization. Among others, Indonesia is inviting Pacific Island Forum, African Union, and then CARICOM. In this regard, the Indonesian government or presidents of Indonesia are inviting the chair of CARICOM to attend the G20 summit in 15 to 16 November in Bali, Indonesia. And it is good, it is coincidence that the chair of this period from July to 2022 is assumed by the President of the Republic of Suriname. So that the President Joko Widodo has extended the invitation to the chair of CARICOM to attend the G20 summit in Bali in 16 November, and with this invitation we hope that Chair of CARICOM could share their vision, their views in the forum of G20. Once it is being invited, So also being invited to a series of meeting of G20, which is approximately 115 meetings. And one of the important meeting is the foreign ministerial meeting in July 7-8, 2020, last month. And His Excellency Albert Tambin, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of International Business and International Cooperation of the Republic of Suriname, was able to participate virtually despite this very busy schedule, because at the same very week, Suriname is hosting the summit of CARICOM, so that we fully understand that Minister Tambin was not able to attend to Bali, but he was participating in the virtually from here. And just to know that the meeting was held in Bali from 10 a.m. to 6 in the afternoon Indonesian time, it means that 12 night here in Suriname. And Minister Tambin was participating during that late night. Thank you, Ibu, on behalf of the government of Suriname for the participation of Mr. Tambin to the meeting. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, we know that throughout 2020 until now, the COVID-19 pandemic continues to be among us. But praise be to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, thank God that amid the challenges, we were able to prevail and remain resilient. The COVID-19 pandemic is a lesson for us to improve global resilience, and in this regard, cooperation is necessary. Throughout the past years, Indonesia and Suriname continue to strengthen our cooperation through diplomacy. Recovery efforts are made between the two friendly countries in due regard to economic as well as socio-cultural cooperation. On September 1, 2020, the agreement between the Government of the Republic of Indonesia and the Government of the Republic of Suriname on visa exemption for holders of diplomatic, service, and ordinary passport entered into force. But, however, pandemic has prevented us to implement this agreement in full. Now we are experiencing some kind of setback here. Now, for Suriname to visit Indonesia, you need to have a visa. But it is, I believe it is a temporary arrangement until the pandemic is gone, and then we can reinforce that thing. I got the news message, got a various call from Suriname to visit Indonesia. Before they did not need to visa, but now they need a visa, and certainly a lot of complaints, but I understand. After being facilitated, free visa facilitation, and then suddenly we have to apply visa, and maybe the very bureaucratic process that takes a long time and hassle there and here, we understand. But I hope that it is a temporary arrangement, and hopefully by next year we can again to implement this measure, this agreement in full. But likewise, also Suriname, the government of Suriname just announced in 1st of July 2022 that all countries, when entering Suriname, need to have a visa. So it is not an exemption now on Indonesia, but also maybe all over the world is having the same case. I hope that gradually we will be able to contain the COVID-19 pandemic, and Surinamers will, with ordinary passport, can enjoy visa waiver to visit Indonesia as agreed, either for transit or stay for no longer than 30 days. Uh, Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Because of pandemic, now the Indonesian Embassy also stuck having activities, open activities, state by state, step by step, not in full force, but now we start having, like, we open again the Kursus Bahasa Indonesia and Kursus Bahasa Jawa. So anyone of you that would like to participate in this course of the media, now we start having this year in May. Despite constraint, diplomacy continues its effort and development cooperation continues to intensify between Indonesia and Suriname. On December 1st, 2021, the government of the Republic of Indonesia and the Republic of Suriname have signed the agreement on the aid program. It is a grant for the welfare of Suriname's people of Indonesian descent in Suriname in the amount of $100,000. More or less, because the grant is in rupiah, in the Indonesian currency, and then it is converted to US dollars. It depends on the rate, exchange rate at the time. But thanks that at the time, the amount is not less than $100,000. So I can say that the amount is $100,000. The grant will be used to finance and the aid program for the promotion of the welfare of Suriname's people of Indonesia, the sentence listing of one, the establishment of documentation center that has been mentioned by Pak Helwin at Sana Budaya, and publication of a book on the commemoration of 130 years of Japanese immigration in Suriname. And the second project is the establishment of a culinary craft and more market at the former sugarcane plantation Marienburg in the district of Komowai. As Indonesia and Suriname have been in constant interaction for years, having shared historical depth, distinct cultural characteristics and tradition, the implementation of this project will move both countries closer together, especially in strengthening the people-to-people ties between Indonesia and Suriname. And I hope, as an ambassador of Indonesia to Suriname, I hope that it is not the first or the only grant that Indonesia and Suriname could afford. Hopefully, there will be more projects that we can work together. The commemoration of the 132nd year of the Japanese immigration to Suriname feels special, as we have reached another milestone with the ongoing implementation of the grant agreement between Indonesia and Suriname. It is creating more solid foundation for conserving the cultural heritage left by our ancestors. I fervently hope that the implementation of this project this year will create more opportunities and help to improve as well as promote the welfare of my beloved Suriname's brothers and sisters. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. As there is saying in Japanese about relationship, "Biting moyo jalanan wanir koso." In English, prosperity comes for those who dare to try. Or if in Dutch, hopefully I read correctly, welfare onstad doordat je is durf te proberen. Is correct? In this regard, as the ambassador of the Republic of Indonesia in Paramaribo, I will continue to try to do my best to further strengthen the already existing friendly relations between Indonesia and Suriname by working hand in hand with all of you here. I'm confident that the coming years will unveil the true potential of Indonesia and Suriname's relation, including the people-to-people contact between the two countries and cooperation in various fields. The government of the Republic of Indonesia, through the Indonesian Embassy in Paramaribo, is always at your disposal to support you. To conclude my speech, allow me to convey my deepest gratitude and appreciation to each and every one of you, my beloved Surinamese brothers and sisters, for your efforts in preserving and safeguarding the valuable Japanese culture. Last but not least, my gratitude to VHJI as the organizer for giving me this opportunity to convey my speech to this respectable audience. I pray for good health and happiness to all of you here tonight. I thank you. Matur kesubur, pedang, geratangi.